Hello everyone, welcome to the next part of The Evil Within. Maybe the last part, I don't know. It seems to be coming along that way. Finally at the hospital, or the asylum, whatever. And it might just be ready to confront. What do you want? Anyway.
I know you're out there.
Yeah.
Listen to me, goddamn.
Okay, I'm listening.
Watch out for his eye.
What?
If you want to live, you avoid Ruvik's eye. Watch out for his eye.
What's that supposed to mean?
You'll see.
Thanks for the tip.
Poor guy. Rest in peace.
Rest in peace indeed. Okay, I'm being led somewhere. Holy fuck! I've really pissed him off! Okay, we need to watch out for his eye. Well, there are a lot of eyes. Oh, great. Shit. Ah, damn it. Oh, shit. Thank you. Are you kidding me? Shit. I thought I shot a flash bolt. I guess I didn't. What am I supposed to be doing now? Oh shit. No. Is that a metal one? Okay, no, it is. This asshole here shooting an RPG at me. I do not appreciate that. Okay. Well, I thought this was the final arena. The music stopped. That's kind of strange. Okay, there's some goo here. Use my syringe. What's with the standstill going on right now? Okay. Intestine floors. I've seriously not seen that guy up there. What a dickwad. I don't want to lose this torch. This is pretty gross, but I can see the obvious 2D behind the textures here. Getting tired of your shit, Rubik. Oh, it's one of these fucking things. Seriously, full on shotgun rounds? Interesting. I have a lot of trap parts, hold on. Falling everything, what do you know? This game is really preparing me for something. Final boss, obviously, but you know. Waiting for Ruben to get his skinny white ass out here. Ah. Well, shit. This is what they were talking about. Okay.
Take that.
Okay, I didn't think they were that stupid. Man, these guys have a lot of health. Oh, shit. Destroyed! Thanks for the surplus of ammunition. That was much appreciated. Seems like I'm hurting for ammo now. So let's just grab everything real quick and move on. Oh boy.
Ruvik, I created this world. You cannot keep me here.
Okay, this is where the eye comes into play. That was a really skinny one. Ah, shit. Oh no. Okay, it's not a one-hit kill, it just takes me back. Shit, that pattern was weird.
Jeez.
Avoid those puddles. How was I supposed to avoid the second one, though? Supposed to go all the way to the end? I don't know. Let's try that again. No upgrade chair? Huh. Might as well save then.
If I make it out alive, I'm never riding in an elevator again.
Why? Ooh. How diabolical. I guess this is it.
Sebastian, get away from him. Sebastian, listen to me. Stop. Your interests are the same as ours.
Look, I get it. You're not just some rookie detective, and this is not just some ordinary kid. You killed Joseph and you shot me. So right at this moment, that's enough reason for me not to trust you.
You're a good man. That's why I... doesn't matter anymore. If you know who this kid is, if you know anything, you know why he can't be allowed to live.
Bullshit. It's Ruvik. He's the one that...
Leslie!
Man, those are some sweet-ass headphones. Yo, this is Salazar. Ah, shit. How anticlimactic. Sorry about that. God damn it. That's really lame. Alright, let's try again. Get on the turret. Do it. There's no cooldown on this, is there? Oh, hey, thanks. Come on, Sed. Fucking grab it. Don't be a pussy. Supposed to hit him from this far. Oh, there we go. Hold still, asshole. I'm gonna have to be a careful aimer with this RPG. Whoa, what the hell? You come up to me so fast that time. Sheesh.
I created this world. You cannot keep me here.
Ruvik.
I'm going to finish this.
Sign, sir.
Leave that one. And those two. They're not going anywhere. No one can.
Ahem.
Detective, are you all right? Is there anyone else?
Just give me some real fresh air.
And that was The Evil Within. Thank you guys for watching this entire playthrough. I'm sorry that it's really fucking retarded. At first I didn't want to talk, and then I started talking. You know, it was a real mess, so I'm really sorry about that. But let's go over real quick what I thought of the game. The gameplay, the gore. Those are the main things that I love about this game. It was fun. I didn't find myself getting bored of it ever. However, the one thing that I have to comment on is the fact that a lot of the game felt pointless almost. I get the basic premise of the game is that you are going through these different mind worlds. So, of course, it's going to drag out and kind of be random, but I didn't feel like I didn't accomplish much for the majority of the game. The story, however, is still very interesting. At least I found it to be interesting. I don't know about anyone else, but for a horror game, for an action survival horror like this, it was actually pretty interesting. It kept my interest, just like the gameplay did. I wasn't bothered by the letterboxing and the 30 FPS like most people were, which is obviously why I didn't go out of my way to get rid of them. But let's see what else. The music was alright, I guess. There's some pretty neat little tunes. I wouldn't say anything really remarkable, but everything seemed to flow together pretty well. I'm actually pretty impressed at how this game turned out. I'm still not sure about the actual ending. I cannot really summarize it at all because I'm still confused on what the fuck just happened. I'm assuming I got out of the machine, but what about, you know, what about everyone else? Where's Kidman? Where's Joseph? We saw the doctor and the policeman from the beginning. Connolly, I think his name is, you know, die. And then we left and saw all the bloody bodies all over the place, just like in the beginning of the game. It's like, how are you supposed to tell what is still a part of the mind world and what is real? I mean, I guess the bodies are real since, you know, SWAT came in and everything and saw everything. It's a very strange way to wrap the game up, but don't give up that. I wonder if they're going to make a sequel. I'm not sure about that, but Leslie and Rubik seemingly got out. We saw Sebastian crushing his brain, but apparently that didn't actually happen. I don't know. I'm gonna have to look it up, see some theories, but for now I cannot make heads or tails of anything. But yeah, that's what I think of the game. I definitely thought it was worth it. The pre-order and everything. So I'm happy about that. Can't say I'm gonna play New Game Plus right away. I still have to move on and do some other series here shortly. But yeah, pretty enjoyable. Very reminiscent of RE4. Wow, Jackie Earl Haley, that's his name, right? He was the voice actor for Rubik. I could have sworn, you know, I heard the tone of his voice, and it kept going back to his name, but I wasn't so sure of myself. Yeah, that low, brooding voice. I should have known. That's pretty interesting, though. Still have quite a few questions unanswered. And like I said, I'm just gonna look it up. Yeah, I don't have much else to say about the game. But I am going to wait and see if there is an after credit scene. Maybe to clear a couple things up a little bit. So I will start this again when it gets to that point. So once again, thank you for watching this playthrough of The Evil Within, and I'll see you in the next one. The next series, that is. So there's no after credits cutscene, but we did get a consolation machine gun. That's always good, and a rocket launcher. And goo! And a model viewer! And New Game Plus! $36? I thought it would be a lot more than that. Oh well. That's surprising, honestly. Cool. Anything? No, just the title. All right, I'm signing out.
Leslie?